Hello, Turtles! For the last 2 weeks, focus remained on the new player experience issues that were discovered in mid-February. These were discussed a bit in previous development log, where Rally of Rockets' title screen got its facelift. Upon opening the game, a debug console would appear, something players would not expect to encounter. Rally of Rockets already has a setting for developer mode, so the console display was tied to this setting and no longer appears for players. It is, however, useful to keep around for testers and troubleshooting issues. A short road trip was taken to northern Georgia, where several days were spent with Dizzy and Indy in a cabin. It was actually quite cold and mostly rainy, but we still got a fair bit of hiking in, including a hike to Springer Mountain, the southern terminus of the Appalachian Trail, where a 2,200-mile adventure began for me almost exactly 10 years ago. Upon return from the mini-vacation, the setting screen of Rally of Rockets became the primary focus. Updating the presentation of the screen with a blurred image versus plain black background resulted in major visual impact for almost no effort. In addition, the controls were updated visually, which also greatly improved the appearance. The screen, however, while looking good, did not function well. The controls were scattered all over the screen in an unorganized mess. The solution was to add tabs to separate the settings into categories like gameplay, graphics, and audio, with perhaps more to come in the future. This led into some framework engine programming efforts to build an object that displays an arbitrarily sized box from 9 sprites sliced up and extended. This had not existed because I had not run into the immediate need until the tab setting screen. I also wrote an article about Make Your Games, Not Only Your Engines, which describes why it was not previously written. Finally, in all this redesign of the setting screen, for better aesthetics and usability, it was also an opportunity to fix an issue with different aspect ratios. The old menu was designed for 16:9 widescreen, and other resolutions sometimes had the buttons falling off the edge. The new design fixed this by rendering it all out at 1080p, placing centered on the screen, and then applying scale. When playing the game, pressing escape would instantly exit the player back to the main menu. Feedback from testers stated a menu was required. A small pause menu was quickly added. Although it does not pause the game, the menu does allow access to the setting screen from within the game. This allows for quick adjustments. Perhaps some items will need to be disabled, but that can be handled in future iterations. Thanks to a stream viewer, the Choconut, for providing a big push and initial effort, a generic bug reporting page was put in place that automatically creates issue tickets in project repositories. This should make it easy for others to report issues and for the issue not to get lost through the cracks. Since the last devlog entry, I worked approximately 32 hours. To keep up with my projects, subscribe and click the bell icon for notifications. I also have a Patreon if you wish to provide financial support, although you can also support me for free with a thumbs up and sharing of this video. As always, Turtles, until later, have a good one.